Beruchim Abayim, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to the Beit Gavil Community Center, where tonight the community is gathered to, Bezrat Hashem, unite together in Tehillim and hearing Divrei Chizuk L'Refuato Shel Moren V'Rabbeinu HaRav Chaim Ovadia Yosef Ben Gurjia, Bezrat Hashem. Before we start with the Tehillim and then have Rabbi Aderet speak for us, Bezrat Hashem, I just want to share with you a very, very quick point to maybe help you understand the importance of tonight's gathering. You know, the Chachamim tell us that God was not satisfied with mankind, with the humanity, until Avraham Avinu came along. He wasn't satisfied, wasn't happy. And the commentators ask, what was wrong with Noach? Noach is tzaddik tamim ayah b'dorotav. He was a tzaddik tamim. Hashem not satisfied. What about Shem ve'ever? They had a yeshiva, yeshivat Shem ve'ever. Abraham's daughter-in-law went to them to ask a question when she had problems with the pregnancy. But no, God was not satisfied. Only when Avraham Avinu came along, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was satisfied. So Morai v'Rabotai, why? Why was Avraham the one and everyone else did not accomplish their mission? So the famous answer that the sages tell us is that Noach, as great as he was, Shem and Ever, as great as they were, they studied, they were tzaddikim, but they were closed off. They didn't inspire the public. They didn't go out to the people. You had a problem, you come to them. They didn't come to you. Avraham Avinu was the first one, Morai v'Rabotai, that actually went out to the people. And he inspired, and he taught, and he explained, and he transformed. He made them into believers in Hashem. So it wasn't just being a tzaddik in the room, it's about going out to the people. That was Avraham Avinu. Morai v'Rabotai, today we're here gathered to pray for the refuah shlema of the Avraham Avinu of our generation. HaRav Ovadia Yosef, Hashem Yichayeh Vishmereu, is not only a tremendous genius in Torah, a man that authored over 50 sefarim, over 50 books, in depth. But Morai v'Rabotai, he found time to go out to the people. He found time to go from one city to the next city to the next city to inspire and to change people's lives. That's the man we're praying for. That's the man that's been leading Klal Yisrael for so many years, who transformed the Sephardic community to become a Torah community. So Morai v'Rabotai, we have to beg and we have to cry to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to give him many, many more years of life. I remember the last time I was by the Rav was a few months ago, and he was sitting in his room and he was writing the fifth volume of Chazan Ovadia and Hilchot Shabbat. And you see, he was merukaz. He was very, you know, focused on his learning, despite all the noise going on around him. And Baruch Hashem, the fifth volume was published. Right now, sitting on his table, we heard in Israel, in the Shiurim, his son was saying that sitting on his table is volume number 6 of Hilchot Shabbat. And he has all the Sfarim open, his notes are all there. Morai v'Rabotai, we have to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that he has his zechut himself to complete that sefer and many, many more Sfarim. Amen. Before we call HaRav Aderet to come here, he took out of his precious time to come and speak here tonight. You should know he's one of the busiest rabbis in the world, but he does for the Tzibur. He goes out of his way for the Tzibur. So we're going to call upon quickly our Chazan Meulal, a man that is known for his great voice, but he's also a big time in Chacham, my dear friend Rabbi Emanuel Partush, who's going to read Tehillim with the community together. We're just going to read two Pirkei Tehillim right now, and then the Rav will speak, and then we'll do more Bezrat Hashem after the Shiur. If everyone has their Tehillim, we'll start off with chapter 121, and then we'll do 130. Rabbi Emanuel Bechavod, it's Kuf Chaf Aleph and Kuf Lamed. So everyone, please follow along. He's going to read one pasuk, you follow him. He'll read a pasuk, you follow him. Everyone, please, put your heart and soul into it, and we shall only hear Bezrat Avol Bezrat Hashem. Bechavod, Rabbi Emanuel. Kuf Chaf Aleph.
Chazak Baruch HaRav Ilan Meirov. שהפרקי תהילים שנגיד יהיו לרפואת כל חולי עמו ישראל ובכללם רבנו חיים עובדיה יוסף בן גורג'יה רפואה שלמה, רפואת הנפש, רפואת הגוף ברמח איבריו ושסה גידיו בריא אולם לעד לעולם
אמן
שיר למעלות אשא עיניי אל הערים מאין יבוא עזרי
שיר למעלות אשא עיניי
עזרי מעם אדוני עושה שמיים וארץ.
עם אדוני עושה שמיים וארץ.
אל ייתן למות רגליך, אל ינום שומריך.
אל ייתן
שומר ישראל. אדוני שומרך, אדוני צילך על יד ימינך. וירח בלילה. אדוני ישמורך מכל רע, ישמור את נפשך. צאתך ובואך מעתה ועד עולם. שיר המעלות ממעמקים קראתיך אדוני. קשובות לכל תחנוני. עם עוונות תשמור יא אדוני מי יעמוד. נפשי לאדוני משומרים לבוקר, שומרים לבוקר. אדוני החסד והרבה מופדות. והוא יפדה את ישראל מכל עוונותיו. חזקים וברוכים. מי שברך אבותינו הקדושים והטהורים, אברהם, יצחק ויעקב, משה, אהרון, יוסף ודוד ושלמה, הוא יברך וישלח רפואה שלמה לכל חולי עמו ישראל ובכללם לכבוד מורנו ורבנו עטרת ראשנו, רבנו חיים עובדיה יוסף בן גורג'יה. הקדוש ברוך הוא ירפאהו ויחזקהו ויאמצהו, יחזירהו לאיתנו הראשון, בריא עולם לעד לעולם, לרפואה שלמה, רפואת הנפש ורפואת הגוף, בריא בנפשו, בריא בגופו, בריא בהנהגתו, בריא בתורתו. ועדי מינן זיווה ויקרא, נזכה לקבל יחד איתו בראשנו, פלי משיח צדקנו. אל נא רפאנה לו, אל נא רפאנה לו. בעבור שכל הקהל הקדוש פעלים בעבורו, וכן יהי רצון ולומר אמן.
Morav Rabotai, now with that, further ado, please welcome HaRav Mordechai Aderet Shalita.
The Torah tells us Moshe Rabbeinu sent the spies to Eretz Israel. He told them, go around Aluzev HaNegev, Alitem Et Ha'ar. And gave him a GPS. Told him, go around. And he added, Hayesh Ba'etz Imayin. Go see if there are a tree. There is a tree over there. Says the Gemara, what do you mean to see if there is a tree? Says the Gemara, Moshe Rabbeinu told them the following. You know, there's a guy in Eretz Israel, his name is Iov, a holy man. You go to Eretz Israel, and after you go around to check, find out where is this guy Iov is. If this guy is alive, then we won't be able to get to Eretz Israel. Here is Moshe and Aaron and Olam Israel came out of Mitzrayim, of Egypt, at the border of Eretz Israel almost. Hashem took them out. Says the Gemara, im yesh tzadik echad, sheyagen alehem. This one holy man that may protect the goyim. Those ones that the Gemara says didn't behave. Description of the Gemara on the goyim that lived in Eretz Israel at the time, far from being holy people. Far. But says the Gemara, Moshe told the spies, listen, if this guy Yov is alive, there's nothing to do. We're going to have to stand on the border and wait till he dies. One tzaddik protects the generation. The Reshaim, the Goyim, Moshe, Aaron, there's a Kenin, the old people, all of Israel, millions waiting to go to Eretz Israel. This one guy can stop the whole thing, a holy man. A holy man can protect Goyim. Even though Hashem took us out of Mitzrayim, of Egypt, even though Moshe Rabbeinu split Yam Suf, we have the man, we have the well of Miriam, we have everything, we can cross. One tzaddik. Gather here tonight, not for Rabbi Ovadia, for ourselves. The mistake. We should not think for a second that we pray for him. He is our shield. If Iov could have saved and protected all the goyim, then Ervat Haaretz, the Gemara talks about those goyim, how bad they behave. People think they're going to come, say Tehillim for Rabbi Ovadia. We say Tehillim for ourselves. It's not for Rabbi Ovadia. He protects us. He is our shield. There's hundreds of years already. We didn't have such what we call a caliber, such a person. I'm not talking about his knowledge, talking his leadership, devoting for HaKadosh Baruch Hu all his life, trying to bring back the Torah to Am Israel, That's hundreds of years we didn't have such a leader. He is our protection. The situation today is not as good as was as yesterday. I was informed today that he needs to have another operation tomorrow. Again, he's on the respirator. We got to do something to show HaKadosh Baruch Hu how much we want him to be around us, to protect us, for us, for Am Yisrael. The Gemara says, when Rabbeinu HaKadosh, Rabbi Ilan Asi was very sick, and his maid went up to the roof, and she said, Elyonim mevakshim et Rebbe, v'tachtonim mevakshim et Rebbe. Upstairs, Hashem wants the neshama of Rabbeinu HaKadosh, Rabbi Ilan Asi, but we need him here. To pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to live with us, our protection, our shield, to lead us to the real redemption b'mehra b'yameinu amen. Now when Rav Liponovich died in Eretz Israel, a mashgiach in the yeshiva, Rabbi Chaskel, the one that led the Mir Yeshiva to Shanghai, to China, and then to America. I asked him, what do you do now? Do you nishmat Rav? The Rav passed away in Gan Eden. What do you do? What do you do for him? You learn Mishnayot for him? He said, no. So I do other things for him. We got to do something to save our leader. I just read Parashat Noach yesterday. The way it says in the Torah is like this. HaKadosh Baruch Hu told Noach to tell the people the flood is coming. 120 years Noach was building the Teva. People walk by asking, what is this? It's a ship. He says, no, this is an ark. I'm going to go inside and you're going to die. Comes the Torah and tells us, "Vayi hageshem al haaretz." The flood, the Mabul, did not start at once. First was raining, nice rain. Says the Gemara, why? Why HaKadosh Baruch Hu did not bring right away sandy? Hashem said 120 years to Noah, tell them, the flood is coming. Says the Gemara, Hashem wanted to see if they're going to do teshuva. Horidan berachamim. The rain started, so-called with mercy, very, very slow motion flood, in order to see if the people do teshuva. 120 years they didn't do teshuva. They're going to do teshuva now. Says the Gemara, Reshaim al pitcho shel gehenom lo chozrim b'teshuva. Says the Gemara, a person comes to the door of the gehenom, he sees his friend on the grill. Have done, or well done. Says, no. What do you say? peppers and I don't know, where's the ketchup? Reshaim al pitcho shel gehenom lo chozrim b'tshuva. Says the Gemara, a person sees gehenom in front of his eyes. He doesn't regret. Doesn't regret. Here comes HaKadosh Baruch Hu and started the flood, the Mabul, with a very, very nice rain. Gishmei bracha. Shema yachzeru b'tshuva. They might do teshuva. They won't do teshuva. They never do teshuva. They didn't do teshuva 120 years. How are they going to do teshuva now because it's raining? And the Torah tells you, who tells Noah, go inside the Teva and bring food for the animals. How long am I going to be in the Teva? Noah looked on the text, doesn't say. How long, how much food I have to bring? Maybe he's going to be around the Teva for the rest of his life. Hashem never told him he's going to come out. Hashem never gave him a date. Let's go, Elohim et Noach. Remember, Noach says the Torah, finally comes out of the Teva. Comes out of the Teva, says the Torah, he went to Yerushalayim, to HaRav Moriah, he built an altar. Sacrifice to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Yarach Hashem et Riach HaNichoach. Hashem smelled the sacrifice. Tells Noach, you know what? Like we say in America, you got me. I promise you, no more Mabul. No more Mabul. No more Mabul. No, you see, I'm going to make a rainbow. No more Mabul. No more Mabul because Hashem smelled barbecue. Why? Because Noah sacrificed, so what? He sacrificed, so he did. But how this is going to protect the world from the new Sandy that might come and destroy the world? If you recall New Orleans, because Noah sacrificed few animals and few birds, then Hashem said, no more Mabul. Hashem loves the smell of barbecue. You know, we live in a little mistake. A little mistake. Yom Chachamim, and invented for us to say brachot. Say brachot. Before we eat, say bracha. After we eat, we say bracha. Sometimes we praise HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we say bracha. When we have thunder, we see a lightning, we see the ocean. Winds, hurricane, tornado, earthquake, the Mishnah, Salacha in Shulchan Aruch, in the Rambam. You have to say, brachot, say brachot. But what you say, bracha? It's nice, you know. It's nice to say brachot. Baruch Ata Hashem, Baruch Ata Hashem, Baruch Ata Hashem. Baruch Ata Hashem, or say Ata, in front of you. Baruch Ata Hashem. And Rosh Hashiva Rav Shach was sick, couldn't eat no more. They put a feeding tube through his stomach. Somebody came to visit him. And he said to him, you know what happened to me? The guy expected to hear, God forbid, The Rosh Hashiva has a feeding tube. So I tell you what happened to me. I cannot say anymore, Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nihiye Bidvaro. I can't put anything in my mouth anymore. People think they do a favor, they say Baruch. You know, Borei Olam could have made us with a battery inside, and before we go to sleep, we plug ourselves like we plug our cell phone. Or cables. What do you think HaKadosh Baruch Hu made it this way? He called our grandfather Adam HaRishon to Galed and he said, Mikol etzagan achol tochel, bechavod, you can eat. I don't want to eat. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says, I wish HaKadosh Baruch Hu would have made me with two mouths. One mouth for eating, one mouth praying and study. Who needs to eat? HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not eat. The angels don't eat. For what? Who needs all those supermarkets? Who needs the whole thing, agriculture? And the person does a favor to Hashem. He mumbles, Baruch Ata Hashem. If he remembers. But it's the opposite. Just the opposite. Hashem gives us an opportunity to say Baruch Atash. It's not because we're going to eat, we say Bracha. Because we want to say Bracha, Hashem gave us opportunity to say Bracha. Says Yov Migdi Mani Vashalem Lo, HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, who is ahead of who? A person does a favor to Hashem, builds himself a mansion, a house, 20 bedrooms, 7-car garage. Then he goes to Safra, he says, do you have a mezuzah? My budget is about $20 to $30. For the chandelier, he paid $300,000. For the carpet, $1 million, Persian one. But the mezuzah, a small one. Says HaKadosh Baruch Hu, said Yov, who is ahead of who? He does a favor, he does a brit milah to his son. Who gave him a son? He puts a tzitzit. Who gave him a garment? When is the last time you say HaKadosh Baruch Hu, thank you very much for giving me a wife. Thank you that I have a father and mother. Thank you. The story one of the Bate Knesset on Rosh Hashanah after the tefillah somebody went to the Aron HaKodesh to the Echal. He tells HaKadosh Baruch Hu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you know, it's after Aleinu Leshabeach. Everybody is going to greet each other, Shana Tova. I don't know how many people will come to you to say Shana Tova to you. Shana Tova! He screamed to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We forget our obligation to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We don't remember. It's not we have to do this because we have to do that. That's our purpose in life. To sing and to thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu will bring a person, will push him to the corner that a person should start screaming to HaKadosh Baruch Hu because he did not scream before, he did not pray before. He forgot about HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Here comes HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the Torah and tells us the following. Ve'et yaleh min ha'aretz v'yishkal kol pnei ha'adamah. Our grandfather Adam, Adam HaRishon, got up and he sees the whole world covered with grass, trees. He looks around and he says, ha, this is going to grow. Without water. Has to grow. Amat v'itpalel, says the Gemara, started to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Ki lo yimtir Hashem. Hashem did not bring rain to Gan Eden, to the world, until our grandfather started to pray, rain. We need rain. I was in England about 40 years ago. It was a big drought over there. Remember, I drove on the highway, signs, English, proper people. Pardon our appearance. Pardon our appearance, the whole thing was yellow. Didn't see one green leaf. Didn't know what to do. Finally, some Chassidei Umot HaOlam, some Goyim decided, we think we have to start praying to Hashem. Started to pray, rain came down. HaKadosh Baruch Hu created Adam HaRishon, says the Gemara, after he created the water. The first creation was water. Says the Gemara, you know what happened? Mikolot Maim Rabim Adirim Mishbere Yam Adir Bamarom Adonai. Says Dari, let me tell you what it means. Let's the mizmor that we say Friday night. Mikolot Maim Rabim. From the sound of a lot of water. Adirim Mishbereyam. The first letter of the word Adirim is Aleph. The first letter of the word Mishbere is Mem. The first letter of the word Yam is Yud. Makes Imi, my mother. Adir Bamarom Adonai. First letter of the word Adir is Aleph. The first letter of the word Bamarom is Bet. Hashem, first letter is Yud, is Avi. My mother, my father. That's how the water praises HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Says the Gemara the following, you know? Mashal lema davar domeh, I want to tell you a story. A king built himself a palace and hired mute people, servants. And the servants came. And every time the king appeared, they couldn't sing, they were mute. But, you know, they moved the mouth, they moved the hands. Said the king, you know what? Why did I bring those mute people here? If the mute people, the servants, they want to sing for me, why don't I bring real servants with a mouth, let them real sing for me. Says the Gemara, ha, Hashem made the world. The first thing was water. The water sank to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Said HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you know what? They have no mouth. Let me create a person with a mouth. Let him sing with his mouth. Let him praise with his mouth. It's our obligation to say Tehillim. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not hear it all the time. And from time to time we have something not as good as we would like to hear. And then we started to say Shira Ma'alot, Shira Ma'alot. And then Hashem said, that's what I meant. HaKadosh Baruch Hu mitaveh letfilatam shel tzadikim. Says the Gemara, Avotenu imotenu akarim ve'akarot hayu. You're going to read this week's parasha. Sarai, Imenu could not have a child. Avraham could not have a child. Then the Gemara, the Torah will tell you in a few weeks, Yitzchak could not, Rivka could not, Rachel could not. Says the Gemara, what is this about? Tzadikim, Avotenu. How come? What's wrong? Nothing is wrong. You do not fulfill your obligation. You don't pray. You don't pray enough. Wasting your life. Watching, talking, reading, nonsense. That's our problem. And for this, HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave a hard time to Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov because they didn't pray enough. HaKadosh Baruch Hu desires the tefillah of tzadikim. What is this? A masochism. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants people to pray. No. You don't understand. He created us for this. This is our obligation. If you don't say bracha before you eat, it means you do not fulfill your obligation. It's not, I forgot to say bracha, I don't know what to say. Gozel et Knesset Israel, says the Gemara. You are a thief. What a thief, what? Of the Nishmat Israel, Knesset Israel, says the Zohar. You don't fulfill your obligation, you don't say bracha. You have to learn the brachot. You have to have a desire to say brachot. You want to say brachot. In Chas v'Shalom, somebody cannot eat, and somebody cannot do what he wants to do. He says, listen, it's not that I cannot do this. It's I cannot pray. I cannot fulfill my obligation. People don't think, do a favor to Hashem. They come to Bet HaKnesset Shacharit, or they come at 11 o'clock. Says the Gemara, Kadosh Baruch Hu comes to the Knesset in the morning and says, where is this guy? Where is this guy? How come this guy didn't come? How come this lady didn't come? What's she doing? No, he is reading the Wall Street Journal. He's checking his email. Before tefillah, says Shulchan Aruch. The person is not allowed to do anything before he praises HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Halacha and Shulchan Aruch. You can't do nothing in the house, only to bring a coffee to you, honey. Can't do nothing. Don't put your bag, don't prepare your bag, don't start nothing. Because your obligation, Modeh ani lefanecha. He created me. I can fulfill my obligation to sing to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's what the Gemara says. This is parasha. Sarah comes to Avraham Avinu after she gave Hagar to Avraham, and she says to Avraham after Hagar got pregnant, she said to Avraham, "Chamasi alecha, chamasi alecha." My Hamas on you. Hamas. Hamas on you. Hamas. So the Gemara, you know what she told Avram? You prayed, huh? You should have a child. You did not pray for me. You prayed for yourself. Hamasi alecha. Hamas. Re'e oivai ki rabu. Misay, every day le David. See how many enemies I have. You know why? Hamas. Don't pray. You don't pray. Yeah, you pray when you need something. I heard once somebody went to a very busy city, Manhattan. He's looking for a parking lot, parking spot. Can't park the car. Every sign, don't park two-way zone. He didn't understand why it doesn't say three-way zone. He sees, oh, somebody moves out. He got it. He says, never mind, I got it already. Thank you. Yeah, he didn't do it for me. I found it. Ilufinu male shira chayam. We have to feel that our mouth is like the ocean, praying all the time. Never finish. Not with Chas Shalom, somebody is sick, in critical condition, everybody says, Tehillim, Tehillim. ויעבור אברהם בארץ עד מקום שכם, עד אלון מורה. Says the Gemara, Avraham Avinu Beruach HaKodesh saw what's going to happen to his children and started to pray ahead, says the Gemara. You pray before. And Nisecha Shebechol Yom Imanu, a person has to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, please, before the tragedy would come. Make sure, I don't want to have any tragedies. When the tragedy comes, it's very hard to cancel the Gezerah. You know why it came? He didn't pray. You have to pray ahead, not after. Hamasi alecha, Sarah said to Abraham. You did not pray for me, you prayed for yourself. So you got this Arab Machshimo Ishmael. If you'd have prayed for me, we'd have Yitzchak, we don't need this garbage, per Adam, Yadoba Kolviat Kolbo. That's what the Torah tells you, you know? Torah tells us, listen. Noach was preaching, telling everybody, listen, flood is coming, flood is coming. Hashem, with his mercy, started the flood with a very calm rain. Very calm rain. So when you see rain outside, it's supposed to ring a bell. It says rain. Oh, where does calm rain from? From Shamayim. You know, when was the first rain? When our grandfather prayed to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Just say thank you to Hashem, this rain. Now it's a drought. So we can't wash our cars. Why? We don't praise Hashem. We don't thank Hashem. Hashem wants us to pray. If we pray ahead, it's going to come. We pray after. Sometimes very hard to cancel the gezerot. It's our obligation to keep our health, to keep ourselves if we fulfill our obligation. Noach spoke to the people. Sister Kimah, Noach did not pray for his generation. Didn't pray. Hashem brought a little rain. Hashem said, you know what? Maybe people will see the rain. They'll start, okay, thank you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Rain, ah, Baruch Hashem. No, didn't say. Mabul started. Noach comes out of the Teva. I said, Mizmor Le Toda. You know, say Shulchan Aruch and Mashiach will come, all the Sidurim that we have, we're not going to use. And Mashiach will come, the dead ones will rise. I said, what are you going to do the whole day? You know what you're going to do? You're going to say, chapter 100 in Tehillim, 100 million times. Mizmor Le Toda. From the whole Sidur, you're going to sing. Might take 5,000 years. What are you going to do? Singing. Somebody is going to ask, what do you do when Mashiach will come? We're going to say, Mizmor Letoda, Ariu L'Adonai Kol Haaretz, Ivdu Et Adonai Besimcha, Bo'u Lefanav Virnana, Diu Ki Adonai, Adov Adov Emunato. That's it. That chapter, 100. Since the Gemara in time of David HaMelech was an epidemic, they couldn't stop it. And David HaMelech figured out, with the help of a Navi, epidemic. People die every day, 100 people more, sometimes more. He says, you know what? You know what the problem is? People don't say thank you to Hashem. Buys a new suit? Yeah. $800. A tie, $500. Gucci shoes. I don't know if Gucci does shoes. Bali shoes. Forgive me. So, say thank you to Hashem? No, he says thank you to the guy over there. Thank you very much. Mucho gracias. When you say thank you to Hashem that he gave you shoes, she'asali kol tzorki. In the morning we say this bracha, say Shulchan Aruch, have in mind, shoes, Baruch Hashem, you have shoes. You go by a tie, you go by a suit, you go by a hat, you go by food at the supermarket. Thank you to the register, thank you. When you say thank you to Hashem, thank you, I have, Baruch Hashem, I can have a shpilo tonight. He does a favor to Hashem, he mumbles something after he ate. That's your obligation. Hashem gave us everything. We should have the chance, privilege to thank him. That's the purpose of the Kaddish. That's the purpose of the Brachot. Says Dari, I became Ari. With the Ruach HaKodesh, like Navi almost. And left Yishma'un, says Rabbi Akiveger in Shulchan Aruch about Ari. He's like Navi. He says, you know why? Because I said the Brachot Bechavana. Because it says, Shehakol Nihiye Bidvaro. I learned what it means. Shehakol Nihiye Bidvaro. He does everything. This is an obligation. Come to the Torah and tell us a story. And tell us a secret. Noach went to the Teva with no date of coming out of the Teva. Torah tells you, Vayizkor Elokim et Noach, Vayashok oto b'teva, Vayaver Elokim ruach al haaretz vayashoku hamayim. All of a sudden, the water calmed down. It says, "B'Torah, Vayizkor Elokim et Noach." Hashem remember Noach. In Parashat Vayetze, Rachel could not have any children. The Torah says about Rachel also. Vayizkor Elokim et Rachel. Hashem remember. Says the Gemara, what do you mean Hashem remembers? Why the Torah writes Hashem remembers? Says the Gemara, I'll tell you what it is. By Noach Hashem remembered. And Noach and his two boys and almost all the animals controlled their desires for 1 year. Stayed pure. Men one side, lady one side. No reform conservative. Vayizkor Elokim et Noach was not eight. Hashem waited. He might end up traveling in the Teva. Who knows how long? Says the Gemara after Noach. And his two boys and the animals control their desires. Hashem said, okay, I'll stop the flood. I'll stop Sandy. Rachel could not have children. Vayizkor Elokim et Rachel, says the Gemara. Let me tell you something. Menashe, the king put a statue in the holiest of the holiest, Kodesh HaKodashim. Don't underestimate this guy. He had eyes with Ruach HaKodesh, and he went inside, and he came alive. And he put a statue with a face. And he looked, and he see, huh? A Kadosh Baruch Hu, he moves. He doesn't want to face that face of the statue. He went and he made a four-way statue. like we have four-way stop sign. And he put in Kodesh HaKodeshi. And Hashem said, what? This is the king that able to see me that I don't want to face this statue. And he put a statue with four sides to chase me out of my house. But I'm going to destroy the world. Says the Gemara, Kadosh Baruch Hu went to Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov and told them it's the end of the world. I'm done. If this is your grandson, Menashe, the son of Chizkiyahu, does it, I don't need Bet Hamikdash, I don't need the world. Forget about it. Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov said, okay, what can we do? Prayed, Shem said, forget about it. Says the Gemara, came Rachel Imenu, to Kadosh Baruch Hu, said, Rachel, yes, what do you want to say? Rachel said, listen, I want to tell you HaKadosh Baruch Hu something. You know, I had my wedding gown on me. And all of a sudden, my father came to me and he said, your sister is the bride to marry the chief, Yaakov Avinu. Can you imagine? A girl is engaged to Yaakov Avinu. Who can be bigger than that? And here comes the father, Laban, and he says, excuse me, step out. Your sister Leah is the bride. He says, Rachel, get out. Leah is the bride. Go inside, stay in the room, goodbye. She's going to get a shidduch? Yeah. She might marry El Capone, Esav. Maybe not even. Finish with my life. So, well, it's not the end of the day. We're going to get home after the wedding. Yaakov and myself made some secret signs between us because we suspected that my father can do something, can make a switch. If I don't tell my sister, Leah, those signs, Yaakov will get home, and he says, and she said, and he said, oh, goodbye. I know who you are. Rachel and Leah were twins. They looked alike. So Rachel said, my sister might get embarrassed. Let me go to my sister. When I give my sister my dress, I'll tell my sister the signs, the secret signs that I did with Yaakov. And I gave it to him, to her. Said Rachel to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you know, I was quiet. Ichnasti tzarati leviti. I brought to my house my enemy, so-called. I lost my husband. I lost Yaakov Avinu. I could have gained him in 1 second. Not in a bad way, not with a hitman. I'm just not getting anything to my sister. And after the wedding, it'll be over. He'll go home, and Yaakov says, ah, you're not Rachel, goodbye. But I didn't. I said nothing. I was quiet. I broke my habits. Somebody is going to ask you why we're here. Says the Gemara, "Mini kolech mi bechi v'enayech midima." Not bizchut Avraham, not bizchut Yitzchak, not bizchut Yaakov, bizchut Rachel imenu. If somebody is going to ask us, how did Noah survive the flood? Says the Torah, "Vayizkor Elokim et Noah, control our desires." Says the Mashgiach in the yeshiva. When the Rav died, he asked the Mashgiach, Reb Chatzkel in the yeshiva, what do you do for the Rav? Mishnayot? Tehillim? He said, no. I break my habits. Like Noach, like Rachel. Let's save the world. Menashe put the statue, Hashem was about to destroy the world. בזכות רחל אמנו. השם דינה לסוואל. כיפה אמר הוא שט. Not to insult, not to answer, not to hate our enemies. Even somebody does something bad to us. Not to keep it. Not to have anything in the heart. Rabbi Chaim Vital, somebody came to Rabbi Chaim Vital, asked him, he said, how come you have Ruach HaKodesh and I'm a bigger Talmid Chacham than you? Let's level it out. What's the secret? He says, I tell you what the secret is. The one that respects me and kisses my hand all the time is equal for me if a person comes and spits at me and insults me. I love you both the same. That's Rachel Imenu. That's Rachel Imenu says the Zohar, the Shekhinah is not in the Kotel. The Shekhinah says the Zohar is in Kever Rachel, Rachel Imenu. To break the habits, to control our desires, that breaks the Gezerot. We gather tonight for Ufa Shlema, Ovadia, Chaim Ovadia, Chaim Yosef, Ovadia Yosef. I'll tell you a secret. Happened to be in Eretz Israel the day before Shana Rabbah. I went to see him. I went inside his room. Critical condition. Critical condition. The doctor said, he's going. All the media was there. Oh, waiting, Bezrat Hashem will die, and they'll be able to spread the good news. Tell you a secret. That day was the day before his Brit Milah, 95 years ago. Kadosh Baruch Hu memalei shnotam shel tzadikim, yom liyom. The Gemara, Moshe Rabbeinu, went up to Shamayim the same day he was born. So one of the Chachamim, he goes by the day of the Brit Milah. Moshe Rabbeinu was born Mahul, so he goes by that day. He was in critical condition. Hashem wanted to take him upstairs. Because this tzaddik goes upstairs the same day of his Brit Milah. But people prayed so much. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Baruch Hu said, okay, let him stay. Am Yisrael broke the Gezerah. Elyonim mevakshim et Rebi, ותחתונים מבקשים את Rebi, יהי רצון שיקברו התחתונים על העליונים. We pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, should leave us and lead us. But it's in our hands. To control our desires. I was in the hospital. They announced, who wants to break his iPhone? Dirfuah shlema shel Rabbeinu. People broke the iPhone. Rav Chaim Kanievsky said, whoever has an iPhone, we're not going to have Olam Haba. No Olam Haba. We have to break our habits, we have to break our desires. We have to love everybody. Like Rachel loved Leah. She took away her husband. She might not ever get married. She gave her the signs. That break the Gezerot. That stopped the Mabul. And that broke the Gezerah of HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted to destroy the world. Of course, our obligation is to pray. But if we didn't pray enough, we should break our habits, stay pure, control our eyes, control our thoughts, stay away from bad environment, bad people, and love each other. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu with His mercy,